on my YouTube channel today. I just wanted to do a quick video about some things that I experimented with lately at my most recent vendor market. One of the biggest challenges that I have faced doing vendor markets is the bigger the vendor market, the less I sell. And you know, logically that doesn't make sense because you think, all right, there's gonna be more people there. If there's more vendors, usually there's more people that come and check it out. This really confused me at the beginning, and then I started seeing some consistencies throughout my vendor markets where there were more than 50 vendors. And I just wanted to share with you a few things that I have learned that help you to stand out at vendor markets. The reason that I think that it's more challenging to do larger vendor markets and you don't tend to sell as much sometimes, at least for me personally, I think the main reason is because my customers, they come to my booth and they're like, I love your stuff, but I'm gonna come back later. I wanna look at everything else first. And probably 8 out of 10 times, those people never come back. I think the reason is when there, you know, when there's 50 vendors or less, there's not that many booths to go around and see. You could probably go through 50 vendors pretty quickly in a reasonable amount of time. And usually when there's that few of vendors, there's not like rows and rows of vendors. So you can kind of remember where everybody's at if you see something you like. But in larger vendor markets of like 50 or more, I think people forget where you are or forget what they saw. Or in some instances, the market is so big, they're tired by the time they've gone through the entire thing and they're like, forget it, I'm not going back. And so I think that that's a very real problem I've seen consistently. Is the customer wants to browse first, then they forget where you are, or they're too tired to come back. I generally have started scaling back from how many large vendor markets that I do, simply because it's not worth the effort. And a lot of times these vendor markets charge more for your booth space because they know it's gonna draw thousands and thousands of people. And so you are out more money if you don't do well. So I've tended to steer away from them because I know that I'm really not gonna make my money back and my time back. But there is a vendor market here locally where I am that draws over 10,000 people, and there are about 160 vendors. When I was debating on whether or not I was gonna do this market, I went and scoped it out first, which if you've watched my top 20 tips for vendor markets, if you're just starting out, I highly recommend watching that video. Anyways, I tell you to scope out the market ahead of time if you can. I knew that I was debating on doing this vendor market, so I went ahead and went as a customer the first time before I signed up, and then I paid attention. And some of the things that I noticed were everybody was shopping. Like, these people came to shop. They didn't come to browse. They were serious about it. Almost everybody was carrying a bag. And so that let me know, okay, this might be worth my time, even though there's 160 vendors here. And one thing that I personally noticed when I was there is it was so big that I got lost. Like, I literally couldn't remember where what was. And so that kind of was a challenge in the back of my mind. Like, if I do this event, how am I going to make people remember me? How am I going to stand out so that they come back? I'm going to share with you some things that I did. The first thing that I did is I got a unique tent. This company called Quick Tent, and I will link their link in the description box below. And they've also given me a coupon code for you if you decide that you want to make a purchase of one of their canopies, and it will be in the description box. But anyways, they contacted me actually, and they didn't know that I was in search of a unique tent, but they asked me if they could send me one and give my honest review about their product. They let me pick any canopy that I wanted, and this event allows a 12 by 12 space. I decided to go with their gazebo canopy because it is an 11 by 11 canopy, and that would allow for more merchandise. But also, the reason that I chose this canopy is because it has such a unique shape and it's also a unique color. So they only have two colors to choose from, and I chose the tan and the cream or beige, however you want to call it, because I thought it looked a little more classy. But I mean, the blue would definitely stand out if you're wanting to stand out. But I remembered at this event, all of the canopies there, just about all, were white. They all had, you know, the basic, same basic shape, and they were all white. So in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, well, I don't want white, because then I'll just blend in with everybody else. The first thing that I did was I chose a different color and a different shape. Now I will say this canopy has some unique features apart from the fact that it's shaped different. They made it more so for like a backyard cookout. It's really not meant for vendors, but it has like windows on each side where you can unzip the windows and roll them up, and it's like a mesh window and it creates a nice breeze. So if you do a lot of summer markets, this is perfect for that. But also in the top of the canopy, there is a raised area where there's like a mesh area where you can get some airflow going through the top of the canopy as well. So for a backyard cookout or whatever, it is like perfect, especially if you live in hotter climate. However, if I get another one, which I probably will, I think I'm gonna go with a canopy that has a solid roof. And the reason that I say that is because it rained on the day of my event, and for the most part, it kept the rain out. Like, it wasn't a huge issue, but I did notice, like, if a gust of wind hit my canopy, it would kind of sort of raise that area, and the mesh portion would kind of open and splatter rain into my canopy. That is something to consider if you live in kind of variable weather, whether it's like high winds or a lot of rain. I wouldn't recommend this particular style, but there were several things that I really liked about this canopy. Is number one, the quality of the frame was like way beyond any canopy I've ever worked with. I've gotten most of my canopies off of Amazon and maybe even a restaurant supply store. They put some sort of protectant over the parts of the frame that is just, it makes it so much more sturdy. And they also don't have those little clicky buttons. They have actual like a push button, so you don't risk getting your finger pinched in between the little holes. So I mean, I really think that their quality is definitely better than most of the canopy tents that I have had experience with. But as far as being like all weather, no, this canopy isn't really all weather. And I also wanted to mention that their customer service is really great. I did happen to have a little tear in the roof of the canopy. I contacted them and let them know, and they're sending me another one. And so they really stand behind their products, and they are really, really great to work with. And I think in our society today, that's actually really great. So another challenge that I think that you face in a large vendor market is not only are people like wanting to browse and come back, a lot of times there's so many people that when they're coming by your canopy and they look inside, they're just kind of like checking it out to see if they even want to go inside. They have a lot of stimuli coming at them and they're swiveling their head all the way around, you know, and they're not really seeing a lot of times what you have to offer. If you've noticed on social media, almost everything is going to videos because as humans, our attention span is getting shorter and shorter, I really think because of smartphones, but videos really just kind of grab your attention more than a static image does. And so I tried to apply that logic to real life and I thought, okay, when people are coming by my booth, I want to put some flashing lights up. And so that flash will kind of get their attention and make them look. The challenge there is you often don't have electricity. So I purchased these battery operated lights from Amazon that had really good reviews. And one of the things that I really liked about them is they didn't just flash one way. It wasn't like two options. They have like, I can't remember how many options. I think it's like 10 ways that you can change up your lighting. And another great feature, which was probably my favorite feature, is it has a remote control that comes with it. So, and it is universal. So I bought 4 boxes and I ended up only using 3, but they all have like a battery pack since you do have to put 3 AA batteries in each one. You can point the remote control to that battery pack area. It'll turn them on and off. It'll change the lighting just whatever, but it is universal. So I just needed one remote for all three strands of lights. One of the things that I did consider was a lot of people have light sensitivities, and flashing lights can actually cause people to have seizures. So that's another thing that I wanted, that remote, so that if somebody was triggered by it, I could turn it off immediately with just a click of a button. One thing that I really loved about these lights is they looked amazing in my tent. It created just such a nice ambiance inside the tent. I personally enjoyed it myself, and then I noticed that my shoppers really enjoyed it. They talked about it. They were like, oh, I love your lights. It looks like Christmas in here. And even though it was during the day, it was an overcast day, and so they really stood out. And plus, I was there really early before the sun was fully up. In fact, when I got there to set up in the morning, it was completely dark, and the lights actually come in really handy because I didn't leave my items in overnight because of moisture. So I just turned on the lights and I was able to see what I was doing. So they came in handy in function as well as for the purpose of getting people's attention. I know that it's not really cost effective for some people to invest in lights, but if you have the money and you know you're going to be in a really large vendor market, I do recommend them because they 100% worked at getting people's attention. I got so many compliments on my lights, and I think it just made people want to shop. I don't know how to describe it, but it was a really great investment in my personal opinion. And if you're interested in the lights, I'll link it in the description box of the exact ones that I purchased. So you can give them a try if you want. So the third thing that I did to stand out at this vendor market was I played music. You kind of have to be careful with this because you have to take into consideration a lot of different factors. Number one, is music already being played at the event where you're going? So if there is, they're not really gonna hear the music. But where I was located, we had music occasionally, but it was real quick stuff. So I didn't have to worry about it being an all day thing. But that was one thing you have to consider, is there music going on already at the fair? Is it gonna even stand out, or is it just gonna be annoying? And then the second thing you have to kind of consider is you gotta pick the right kind of music. I did a poll on a Facebook group about, should I play Christmas music at this thing? Because people are gonna be Christmas shopping. And 100%, there were tons of people Christmas shopping. But I got such opposite views. Like, if I heard Christmas music, I wouldn't step a toe in there. Or, I love Christmas music, it's never too early, you know? So, because it was such polar opposites, I thought, okay, if it's causing this much of a argument, then I probably need to stay away from it. Even though, you know, people are Christmas shopping, some people like it, a lot of people don't. So I just decided to forego the Christmas music. Instead, I decided to do Norah Jones radio station on my Pandora, and people loved it. Personally, I loved it. I loved listening to that just relaxing music all day. And then I noticed that when my customers came into my booth, they were like relaxed. They were shopping, they were taking their time, they weren't in any rush. And I really feel like between the lights and the music, it just created a kind of atmosphere that made them want to just hang out. And another thing that you need to consider when you are putting music in your booth is you don't really want music loud in your tent. I considered that. I have a hard time hearing anyways. I'm partially hearing impaired. And so I didn't want to have to try to hear what my customers were saying above my own music. And for it to be able to do what I wanted it to do, which was get attention, I needed it to be a little bit loud, right? Because there's tons of people. There's thousands of people at this event. So what I did to combat this was I got a shower speaker that was one-sided so that I could project music out of my canopy tent, but not in my tent. And the reason I got a shower one is because it's waterproof, and it was a good thing because it rained that day. It also comes with like this little clip, and it's perfect. It's like little, it's compact, it doesn't take up much room, it has 10-hour battery life. So I just hung it on my canopy in a corner where it would project sound out but not in, and it worked amazingly well. Like, I can't even begin to tell you. The thing that I wanted to happen was everybody be like, I hear music, where's it coming from, right? It really did work. All three of these things worked so well that the people across from me were, I could tell by their body language that they were a little bit upset. And I don't know that they were upset at me per se, but I think they caught on that it was very obvious. Everybody that passed by our booths always looked at me and never at them. And I'm not saying that boastfully because I would never want to take sales from someone else. Like, I want everybody to succeed. But that's how well these things worked, that when people were walking by my booth, and I mean, I'm sandwiched across from somebody else, it didn't matter which way they were going, they always looked at me. And it got to the point where the people across from me were actually getting out of their booth and stopping people to tell them about their product, because my tent was drawing so much attention. And I feel like that's a win. Like, I wouldn't want to take sales from somebody else, like I said, but I feel like it showed me that that's how well the things that I was doing was working out at getting people's attention. Between the different shape of my tent, the different color of my tent, the flashing lights and the music playing, it not only created a like boutique feel, but it caused people to stop in their tracks and come on in. I really just think that they really, really worked. And I wanted to share those tips with you. One more thing before I go. I've noticed that a lot of crochet vendors have started putting rugs in their tents. And it does look great. It really does. And I really debated doing it. But the reason that I didn't, that I chose not to, is because I thought of myself. I'm extremely clumsy. If somebody were to trip over an unnecessary rug in my booth, I could be liable and they could sue me. Especially if they broke something, I could have to pay their medical bills. For it to be unnecessary, I didn't think it was worth the risk. And another thing is usually if you're outdoors and stuff, it's gonna get nasty. And you're already carrying so much stuff, like I can barely fit everything that I need to take with me into two vehicles at this big event. A rug just isn't logical to me. It didn't make a lot of sense, and it would take up a lot of space, and it would get filthy. So I just decided to forego that. And I wanted to just let you know my thoughts, not that they really matter, but if you've considered getting a rug for your booth, just take all that into consideration, because you could be held liable for an injury. So anyways, I hope these tips helped you today. If you decide to try them, let me know how they work for you. I will link everything that I used in the description box below. And if you have any other ideas of things that you can do to stand out at a large vendor market, let me know. Or if you found some other challenges at large vendor markets or even small vendor markets and you want some ideas, I love to brainstorm. Just message me or comment below and let me know, and I'll think about it and see if I can help you come up with a solution. So thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, please subscribe. And if you liked this video, please give me a thumbs up. Thanks so much. Oh,